Almonds are really good for our spinal health, for helping backache and neck pain. So we're going to work on standing twists today. Inhale, bring your arms up, palms together, and come into a squat, squeezing the knees together and bringing the pelvis down as low as you can. Trying to get the thighs more and more parallel to the floor, just breathing here. Exhale, when you're ready, fold forward, bring your forehead to your shins. Uttanasana. Inhale, lift the arms up, come back into chair. And exhale, we're going to twist out to the left side, so bring the right elbow to the outside of the left knee. Palms together, looking out over the left shoulder, staying here for a few breaths. And look towards the floor, inhale, lift the arms up. And exhale, fold forward, straighten the legs. Inhale, look halfway up, and exhale, step or lightly jump back to chaturanga. Inhale, open the chest, upward dog, and exhale, come to downward facing dog. Just breathing here. Continuing with our spinal health twisting theme for today, I'm going to come into a downward dog twist. So just bring the right hand to the outside of the left ankle. Look out under your left armpit. So we're turning the chest out to the left side, twisting the whole spine. Returning the right hand to the front. When you're ready, swapping sides, left hand to the right ankle. I'm really trying to open up through the heart. Bringing consciousness to the knots and stuck areas in life. Twisting is really good for this. Come back to downward dog. When you're ready, come back to the top of your mat. Coming into Uttanasana, straight legs. Inhale, bring the arms up, coming back into invisible chair or Utkatasana. And exhale, twist out to the right side this time. Bring the thumbs towards the heart, looking out over the right shoulder. Right elbow pointing straight up to the sky, breathing into the belly. Inhale, lift the arms up, stay down in your chair, and exhale, stand tall, bring the hands to your heart. So it was an easier version of standing twists. Do a more advanced version now. Inhale, bring the arms up, coming again into Utkatasana. Exhale, twisting out to the side. A few variations, you can open the arms out, bring the right fingers to the floor, and if you like, bring the left arm behind the back and bind the inner right thigh, looking up towards the sky. Inhale, open the arms, bring the palms back together, look down at the floor, press into your left foot and step the right foot back. If you need to, come down onto the right knee for balance. We still have the left elbow pointing up towards the sky. If it's available to you, float the right knee up off the floor, come onto the ball of the right foot. Variations, you can open out the arms, you can bring the left arm over the head, palm facing the ground, or if you like, you can take the bind. If you don't know what the bind is or you're not too familiar with it, don't worry about it. This is a more advanced option. After a few breaths, bring the hands together, come back to the floor. Inhale, lift to one leg down dog, and open the knee out, open the hips out to the side. Inhale, when you're ready, straighten that left leg and bring the foot back to the floor in downward facing dog, breathing into the belly, tucking the tailbone under. Inhale, stepping to the top of the mat, folding forward with an exhalation, and then inhaling, bring the arms up, come back into Utkatasana, fierce pose, and exhale, twist to the opposite side now, really challenging the thighs, coming into any variation you like. Opening the arms, taking the bind, we're twisting or wringing the organs out like a dirty face cloth. Very cleansing, all these twisting and lateral postures. When you've had enough, after 5 breaths or so, you're going to step that left foot back, staying in your twisted prayer. You can bring the left knee to the floor if you wish. Coming into any arm variation, you can just keep the palms together if you prefer, that's easier. You want to challenge yourself, bring the right arm over the head. And if you like taking the bind, you can either grab a hold of just the fingers, or you might want to grab a hold of the left wrist with the right hand. Straightening out that arm. Peel the right shoulder back. When you're ready, open the arms out. Return the hands to the floor. Inhale, lifting the right leg up. And exhale, Inhale, open the hips out to the side, keeping the left heel glued to the floor. Inhale, straighten the leg, and exhale, come back to downward facing dog. Stepping the feet out, walking the dog. Deep, easy breaths into the belly. Relax, stretching at the backs of the legs. When you're ready, coming back to the top of your mat. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale, bring the arms up. Again, coming into our seated chair. Strengthening the thighs and gluteals. Look up to the hands if the neck is okay. When you're ready, standing up tall, you come back to Samasthiti. Even balance, hands in front of the heart. Today I'm just going to make a really simple nut and date salad. The nuts and dates usually go really well together. I've got a little bit of spinach here, just chucked that in, just washed and torn up a little bit. So if you tear up the spinach instead of cutting it, you'll actually not cut into the cell wall of the plant so much, so that'll retain more nutrients, just a little hint. Also got some silver beet. Same, torn up instead of cut up. And got some radishes here. Now radishes are really nice little vegetable. Adds a different flavour. If you've never tried them before, I highly recommend it. Some carrots. Similar. So these are Dutch carrots. Really lovely to buy in a bunch because then you can use the green tops for green smoothies as well. A little bit of beetroot. Just to add some colour. Onion. Because I love onion. Could you use something else if you wanted? You don't have to use onion if for whatever reason you don't eat onions and garlic. Some Buddhists or Hare Krishnas or other religions don't eat them. And that's fine. You can use other things like asafoetida or herbs, spices, other things to give the salad a little bit more flavour. Got just some tomatoes, vine ripened tomatoes, usually a lot yummier than the field tomatoes that you get for $3 a kilo at the supermarket. A little bit of lemon juice, squeeze that over the top. So in your salad you want a nice balance of sweet, sour, crunchy and savoury generally, and that's what makes a really good salad I find. So the lemon obviously giving it that sour taste and alkalizing the entire salad. Lemons are one of the most alkalizing foods you can eat, and that's always going to be really good news for our bodies because most of the time our bodies are more acidic than they need to be. And here we've got some chopped up medjool dates. Just dice them up a little bit. Just put them in and that will add really beautiful sweetness. You can use any other kind of dried fruit, so raisins or, you know, even chopped up figs or normal Iranian dates. And last but not least, actually second last, we've got tamari almonds. Now I've let these marinate for a little while. And all it is raw almonds. If you can get activated almonds, you have access to them or you know how to make them even better, then that's even better. But these are just raw almonds with a bit of tamari and some raw honey, all just mixed in together. Really, really beautiful. That's your savoury part. Throw all that in. And last, I've just got a little bit of whole grain mustard. So that gives it heaps of flavour. Just give that a bit of a mix. And it's a fair bit of salad here. This is probably enough for two people. And that's that. If you can have a big salad for lunch most days, you're going to be feeling pretty good throughout the day. Salad doesn't take as much energy to digest as some heavier things, so bread, sandwiches, stuff like that, or even some cooked foods. Whoops. Just make sure you chew everything really well. Give your digestive system the best chance to absorb all the goodies in that.